In this video, we will see about the debugging in Visual Studio. So first of all, you should know what is meant by debugging. So debugging means executing the program of line by line and tracing the program. So tracing will help us to find out any debugs, any bugs in the program. So if a program is executing but not giving the perfect results, so what we will do? So then we will test manually. So for that, then there may be something wrong in the program also. So to find out the mistake, we have to trace the program and check it. So we will do manually, but in this video we will see by using Visual Studio debug program selection. So in this debugging, we have to keep a breakpoint at any statement of the program, so then we can check the debugging, how the process will be gone. First of all, we should create a new project. So click on this new project and click on console app C++ Windows console. So click on next. So my debugging visual. So I am creating the name as my debugging visual. So click on create. So the project will be created. So here the project will be created. So remove all these things. So I am writing one of the program here. So in this program we will see this debugging process. So first of all, what will be there, and the initialization of the values, and finally the values of the variables will be there. What will be the variables of the values, we will observe step by step. So for debugging, we will keep a breakpoint at particular one point. So at the starting only, I am keeping the breakpoint. For breakpoint, click on left side. Here you can see this black strip, so for cement strip colored. So click on this one, this line left side, line number left side, you click on this one. So red color mark is observed, you can see this. So this is a breakpoint, you can on and off. So the breakpoint is on and off, so we can on like this, and or first we will execute. So debug, start without debugging, is it running or not, we will check this. So the value is 15, it was running out. So the sum value of the array values are 15, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 is 15 only. So it was running out successfully. So we will debug now. So how the process is going or not, we will debug. And we will watch what are the variables. So for debugging, click on debug, start debugging, click on start debugging. So you can see this under this here at the first sum variable is -8589934601. What is this? This is an integer type value, and this is an garbage value. So at first the zero value is not assigned so to the sum variable, so that's why it displayed as this garbage value. So I did not go to inside, so that's why for going inside of this, so click on debug and click on step over. Step over means we have to go inside the step. So next step, so next line, so click on step over. You can see this watch list here, you can see the watch list is changing, watch list will be changing. So click on step over. So here you can see this A variable is of int of 5 values and sum variable is assigned as 0. So here again click on step over, or you can click F10 also. So click on F10. So now it is initialized as a value is initialized as array of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 values. And click on debug again, step over. So here you can observe that firstly x value is in come inside the a, and a is assigned to x. This is for each loop. So you can observe this a value is assigned to x. So and next we will observe this sum value is 0 and plus 1. So find here the sum value is assigned with should be assigned as 1 here. So click on debug, step over. So you can now you can see this sum value is 1. Step over. So sum value is 1. You can see the in this console output also. So click on step over. So again you can see this next value is 2. So x value is 2. X 2 plus 1. Sum value is 3. 3 plus. So again do this F10. I am clicking on F10 on the keyboard. You can observe here also in this output. Clicking on F10. So 6 plus 4. And sum value is 10. Here 3. Again I am clicking on F10. 10 plus 5. This is 4. So finally the sum value is 15. So whenever the values are empty, it will exit from the for loop. So the values are empty, it was exited from the for loop, and now this is here in 13th line. So you can see this, it will be printed now. So cout value, sum variable value will be printed out here now. So I am going from this block. So here you can see this sum value is 15. So finally this is the process of debugging in this Visual Studio. So if you understand clearly, please like, share and subscribe this Omkar Computer Education channel. Thank you for watching this video.